Hello. Good afternoon. My name's Belinda Manning. And I'm hoping that there's more than me hanging out here. So poke your heads in. Let me see who's there. I don't like being alone. I see someone's raised their hand. Anybody else gonna raise their hand? Let me see your faces. One thing I hate to do when I'm teaching yoga on Monday nights is that I don't like teaching to the screen. It's really hard for me to make a connection with people when I'm teaching to the screen. So Sandy Parker, let's see your face. Let me see your face.
Oh my gosh. I don't know how to do this. Oh wait, is this?
Okay, start video. Okay, I see you. Good to see you.
Good to see you too. It's been a long time.
It has. Yes, it has.
Do you know Gwen Diaz?
Yes, I do.
Gwen is out here. I'm in Sag Harbor.
All right. Good place to be. We're going to play a little bit today. But who else is out here? I see Lisa. Hi, Lisa. I haven't seen you in a long time. The yes, last time I saw you, your hair was purple. Do you remember?
Yeah, and now it's all. Yeah.
Lisa, this is Sandy. Sandy Hi, and I went to school together.
A million Hi, years ago. Mm-hmm. Hi, Lisa.
Nice to meet you.
And good I see Michelle see down too. Here.
Sorry I missed the purple hair.
Right.
It'll be back eventually.
We cycle these things, right?
Yeah. Well, I got some new color changes going on. So I got to see how it all shakes out.
We all have new color changes going on.
Michelle and Lisa. Sandy.
And there she is.
And Belinda.
Hi, Michelle.
So let me tell you a little bit about me and dolls.
Okay.
I became really interested in doing dolls about maybe 15 years ago. And the way I started was I was doing flame work, which is working with fire.
Okay.
And when you're working with fire, you're leaning over a flame and working with glass. And I wanted to make little glass fairies, but my back was so bad I couldn't stay in this position. So then I started with clay. I started working with clay. And the thing about clay is that it's so malleable.
You're on this camera, not this camera.
Okay. I'm so malleable. It's so malleable that you can make a mistake and start all over again. But the kind of doll we're going to make today, or talk about today, and you may want to make them at another time, but the kind of doll that we're going to work on, it's called a memory doll. So there's a process I use for making memory dolls. And I'm going to show you just a couple of my memory dolls. This is one. And she's my Advent doll. Because she reminds me of the season of Advent. She's got wings. She's got a lot of gold in her because I think of halos and those kinds of things when I think of Advent and Christmas time. So this is my Advent doll. And she has a lot of sparkle on her. She has no face. That's one kind of memory doll. This is a memory doll I made after my father passed. And there's a little face here, you see, and I'm going to show you where you can get the forms to make these kind of faces. And the other thing that this particular doll has, my father had a little lapel pin that was a dove. And so this doll holds that memory of my father. And if you look real hard, you'll see a little piece of, see that piece of lace right there? Can you see that?
Yeah.
That's a piece of the veil from my mother's wedding gown. So it allows for the two of them to be together for me in a place. And when I did her face and her hair and all, she has a ghost-like quality to her somewhere else. The last memory doll I'm going to show you is my menopause doll. And any of you who have gone through menopause know this face. It can be the most excruciating pain that you're like on fire. The heat is like you're on fire and there's nothing to cool you off, especially if you wake up at night. So this memory doll holds the memory of me experiencing menopause. So what I thought we would do today is talk about either the things you've brought with you that you want to use, or talk about the things you would like to collect. Because I thought what would be interesting would be, and this is what I've started collecting things for, I wanted to look at the last, since May, I'm gonna say May 17th, because my daughter stopped working on May 17th. That was the day she walked off her job to start working from home. And has not been back since. So I use March 16th as the time. And from March 16th until now is a point in time in my life that I don't want to forget. And I want to mark it. And I think that there are a lot of things that when my grandmother died, we went through her attic. And it was really fun to do. But one of the things I found there was old ration cards, rations from the war, where, you know, they only got a certain amount of whatever. And it surprised me, number one, that she hadn't used it. But I wanted to know more about that ration card. And there was nobody to tell me the story. So what I like to do when I find things that belong to me or that are important to me is to create a doll for them to hold that memory. It's like a three-dimensional journal. And there's a process I use to do that. And the first thing I do is find music that I enjoy. And I put that music on. And then I find the things that I've collected. And I look at those things and I try to make meaning of them. And this time has been particularly meaningful for me, because in a short period of time, a great many things have happened. There was the pandemic. It was Black Lives and George Floyd. And just now there was the death of this man, John Lewis, very special man. So there are two things I need to do when I do a memory doll, is that I try to balance things out so that I have some of what is joyful about the period and something that is not so joyful about the period. So did everybody bring something with them? And if you didn't bring anything.
I didn't today. I was working on my other projects.
So I know you were
listening in.
I know you were. So how about you, Sandy? Did you bring anything?
I'm away from home. I haven't been in my house in about 14 years.
Wow.
So
you got a lot of memories, honey. Pencil and a piece of paper.
Right now I'm just cleaning, but I have a pencil and a piece of paper.
Good.
Yeah, I am okay. Writing.
Okay. You have a pencil and a piece of paper, Michelle? How about you, Lisa?
I got one. I have to go get it, though.
Yes, I do.
Okay, I'll wait for you.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay.
We'll see you, perhaps.
Judy does not know how to get her face on. Okay, Judy, there is a...
Belinda, if Judy's on a desktop, it's not visible. Sometimes you have to hover your mouse over the bottom left-hand corner. Right. And you will see a microphone and a video, and they'll have a red line through it. So just click on that video and you'll come up.
Can you hear Judy?
Yes. I don't have a mouse, but yeah, I've got it now.
Okay. Or however you hover.
There she is. Hi. There we go. Ta-da.
Still can't get there, Judy.
Pardon me?
Hey, Judy.
Judy and Diane can't get on. Okay. What are you on? Can you hear?
Yes, I can hear you. Sure, I can hear you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Diane, can you hear? Diane, if you're on a laptop, if you have a mouse, hover over, okay, now right next to where, go down, unmute, very good. Now next to that should be the camera. Yeah, girl.
Got it, hi everybody.
Okay, do you have a pen and a piece of paper, Diane?
I do.
You do, okay, this is what I'm gonna do. I want you to close your eyes for a minute. You can all close your eyes for a minute. And drop your shoulders. Just let them sink down. And inhale through your nose. And exhale through your nose. Very slowly. Just inhale and exhale very slowly. And so take a trip back in your mind to before. Before COVID. Before protests. Before blackouts and loss of electricity. Before teacher training, before 48 blocks, and place one hand on your heart. And place the other hand on your belly. Sitting tall, but with your shoulders away from your ears. Relax. And breathe in very slowly. And exhale very slowly. And find in your mind a color. And make it the brightest of that color that there is. If it's red, it's the brightest red you've ever seen. And if it's blue, it's the most luscious blue that you've ever seen. And inhale. And exhale. And now think of five things that you want to remember. Five things that tell the story of your walk from March until today. Five things. Think of five things. And when you have those five things, in your mind, look at each one of them and think about what is it about this thing that tells the story of me? What do I need to tell somebody about me that this thing, this item represents? Five things. Just five things. And breathe in. And breathe out. And mark the image of those things somewhere in your body. And know that even before you marked them there was already an impression that those things had on you, which is why you selected them. So take three breaths now and open your eyes. And you can put your hands down. Take a deep breath. And then on your paper, write what those five things are and the color that you saw. You have them? Di, you got yours, Sandy?
I do.
You do?
I do.
Okay. Lisa? All right. I'm gonna go first. Because I want to go first. So, you know, this is one for me. The other one is this one. This image of our children at school. And I found this saying to go with that, that says the children are not all right. I don't know if you can see that. It's probably backwards. Yeah. Is it good?
Yeah.
The children are not all right. And that's something else I wanted to use. A mask. And the hurricane that we just went through. Probably play us five, but I got this watermelon yesterday. Can you see that? I cut that watermelon open and I couldn't believe how much it looked like female organ, right? Fallopian tubes and eggs, right?
Yeah.
So those are mine. Who else wants to share theirs?
I can tell you what I selected.
Okay.
My color was purple.
Mm.
And I forgot that I was actually wearing a purple dress today. You probably can't see it, but I got in a purple dress. And my first item was, after the pandemic, I live in Washington Crossing in Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. And my daughter lives in Brooklyn. And it took me a while to convince her that she needed to come to Pennsylvania. And so my second item was getting myself in my car during the time that we were locked down. Mm. And with great horror, driving into Brooklyn and telling her and her boyfriend to get in my car, in the trunk of my car, with their masks and their gel. Mm. And I had put in extra clothing so I could make a beeline back to Washington Crossing. So, and the next thing was Washington Crossing itself, just being in that community. And the other thing was thinking about Sag Harbor, where I am now, and actually longing for being here. And the fourth thing was a friend of mine, Bobby, who was in a retirement home, who passed away about the second month of this pandemic. And it's funny, I've thought of her off and on, but not as emotionally as it's making me now. And the last thing was telemedicine.
Yeah. One of the things I'm going to urge you to do when you start to try to put your doll together is to find maps that show those places that you went. One of the things I do when I describe, could give these little tags. And take a string and attach it to the doll. Okay.
Okay.
But I'm gonna show you how to do how to use the map or paper. How you can use paper in construction of your doll.
One other thing. I'm a docent at Grounds for Sculpture. And about 2 or 3 years ago, we had, I can't think of the woman's name. She's a Black woman who does sewing and weaving and glassworks. And she did a piece. She did two pieces on Sojourner Truth. One that was a permanent piece, and the other one was a piece that would evaporate. But she too did dolls. The whole thing was jewelry, putting jewelry into the dolls.
Nice.
It has tremendous significance.
What you got for us, Michelle?
I, you know, didn't do it right, but I went with it now that we've finished. I have to go through and think of the items. But the color was orange. I may have thought maybe root chakra or something, and orange popped into my head. Because I think I had first started with like a bright pink, and then I realized I didn't want to make a pink doll. So then I think my mind changed the channel on it. So I have yoga. I have to think about, I don't have the items. I have to, I wrote down the things that
that's like, good. The no,
chapter. And then now I have to, after class, find an object. But I have yoga. I have the loss of a significant friendship. I have a microphone.
Okay.
And or bicycle. That's how I kept myself busy. I have checking on friends and also those in the community that were elder statesmen to me. And then I have pride. And when I talk about pride, it has to do with sort of the government recognizing gig workers and my friends checking on me, or, you know, dropping things off or throwing a tip in the tip jar when I would do live shows. Like, I think that it was just, I think my friends were concerned with having lost my income and sort of maintaining my pride, I think. And I, you know, I don't even know what these objects would be, but I that's the things.
Yeah. And I think, you know, some of those things may not look like the thing, but it may be an object that you touch, that when you touch it, it reminds you of the thing. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So, and sometimes we have to construct things.
Yeah.
So, like, I went on the internet and found a bunch of stuff, and I also, like, took pictures of one of the things I found in my yard one day was a dragonfly. So I took a picture of one, and I'm going to cut that out and use that because it was really pretty.
Yeah, some could be pictures. So
yeah. So make sure you write those things down though, because you know, the time goes so fast, and then we wish we had remembered, you know?
You're right. I mean, even it's stuff that was like so important just kind of like goes away. Like, I just saw somebody had a birthday parade, and I thought, like, are we still doing that? We can kind of go out now. Where are we still doing birthday parades? So it, like, you know, and I forgot all about those. And that was a lifetime. That was, if you're turning 21, 50, 75, the birthday parade drive-by thing meant a lot to you in April.
Right. And I think I forgot about birthday parades. I want to do something with that too.
Yeah.
I think it's a unique thing that happened, you know?
We did it for Lintega.
Forever, but at least it was unique. It came about as a result of what happened.
But I already just forgot about it. I'm like, well, that's stupid. Why did they do one yesterday? They can just go out and sit somewhere and have a birthday party. So, you know.
Okay. What you got, Lisa?
Yes, to unmute.
Okay. Well, this has been good. I actually have a bunch of stuff. I have some specific things and then some emotional stuff. But one thing is I have this we have this coffee filter holder. It's very kind of retro looking, space age, but it reminds me that the whole time I was at home, I was very intentional. I have this process by which I make myself a cup of coffee and I sort of stuck with that, you know? So that to me is sort of, it's an object that is really intentional and, but every, you know, every day. So I like that about it. It sort of just kept at it I kept at it. I have a couple of Zoom backgrounds from photographs. I would probably use those photographs because I live on Zoom. You know, I learned things about Zoom just so, I mean, right now I'm sitting in the dark. I know I shouldn't be doing that, but you know, hey, it's the weekend. And so something with that, and I too would have a mask. I bought some masks from, you know, some artisans online. I thought I was buying this very beautiful pattern. I love the colors. And then when it came, it was a baby Yoda mask. but I've grown to love it. So it's my baby Yoda mask. And then a microphone, because my husband and he's got guitars and had started to play music in Florida. He and his brother were down there to keep themselves busy. And we were separated for a good part of the thing. And he was playing music and down there. And then when he came home, we started playing music up here and I started singing.
Wow.
And,
Just the two of us.
Yeah, cool. Or also his brother will come and so it's just been a lot of fun. And it's, you know, that's been a wonderful outlet and just, you know, I never did it in any sustained way before. So it's just great. And then a lot of tears. I would figure out a way to represent tears. And also rage, because I find myself in a righteous rage a good deal of the time. So, but also something to represent sort of creativity and excitement, because I have to solve problems all the time and come up with scenarios for things. And there's something exciting and meaningful about that. So the work is meaningful and I want to represent that somehow.
Good.
So those are my things.
Okay. Diane, I see you jotted yours down in the chat.
Yeah, I did. I the picture that's behind me, I think you'll recognize it, Belinda.
Yes, I do.
Allie and Joey, and it's been in their window since the beginning of this. Joey being my 2-year-old granddaughter and Allie, my daughter. She took it down the other day, which shocked me. They were doing something. And I did ask where it was. And here I can have it for my birthday. But to pull up and to see my biggest loss in all this was the loss of my time with them because I work in healthcare. So I was person non grata after usually seeing my granddaughter 2-3 times a week, sleeping over. So yeah, a lot of tears. There'd have to be something with salt and tears. Probably be something with a Q-tip, because I think I've had about 8 of those stuck up my nose, being that I work in healthcare. So yeah, the fast, the face shield, and I'm not around that many people. But I did walk in the second rally in Atlantic City. It's really funny. I believe it or not, I didn't say anything to my daughters that I was doing because I didn't want to hear not to. So there'd have to be something with that movement and that walk. You know, that I was proud of that. I have a rough time with my job being so public that I can't. A lot of times I want to put things up on Facebook and I have to watch what I say, and I hate to be one of those silent people. So that was the day I got to be not silent. Just within the past 2 weeks, my granddaughter is now staying with me again at night. And I feel we have this baby pillow. And I have, which is one of how, but it started from my house. I have a small decorative pillow that she constantly sleeps with. So I actually got to have her back in my bed, back with baby pillow. So that was the positive thing. And there'd have to be something with the beach, not being a huge beach lover, but that's where I've spent many healing hours. Friends would meet. We'd be 6 feet apart. It has been a lifesaver, a little bit of normalcy in all this. So yeah, there are things that come to mind with me. So.
Okay, so I'm going to give you some ideas.
Okay.
Boxes, wine boxes, cigar boxes, because they open and they close. And they have a lot of space. And this is one that I'm going to use. Because he fits right on. And the only thing you have to do to make this happen is use a little of Mod Podge or Elmer's glue and water. Remember how you used to do that when you were a kid and make those bottles? It's the same process, okay? So what I would do with this is I'm going to use this box, and I'm going to use one of these balls, probably a bigger one than this one. I need to find a bigger one. And that would be the head. And I have a lilac bush that broke, and I was really a little upset about it, but I'm glad now because I can use it for arms for the side of this. But inside, I can tell the story by lining this with different sayings, like I found this one, and I'll probably put that in there. I'll probably put a good one, right? A bunch of stuff out there, honey.
I couldn't read it. You have to tell me what it says.
Oh.
What's it say, Belinda?
I'm sorry.
I love it.
You have to get the bottom of it. The bottom. She couldn't see. I couldn't see the bottom.
There you go.
Yeah. And then, you know, I'm going to find some, you know, you have I will probably make two dolls for this period, because I'm going to do one for this period till now, because I feel a little looser now than I felt in the beginning of this period. And so I think that a lot of stuff is going to be taken up with one. So I'm going to have to use another one. Now, this one is the one I started for this process. And I'm going to show you how easy it was to do her. She's wearing a mask, right? This is yarn. I always have a lot of yarn around for hair. And this was an eye that I saw, because I have one of the things that's happened for me with COVID and this period of time I've had is that it lets me see things more clearly. I see more clearly. I'm more present because I had to stop. So I want to remember that when I start getting all you know, antsy and all of that. I want to remember to stop and sing sometimes, you know, because that's a good thing too. It just kind of like helps air in and out. I want to do more yoga. But what this is on the bottom, let me see if I can, I'm gonna take that off. It's glued on. Let me just, and I want you to see this. Because this here,
it's like
nothing more than a stocking. It's a stocking. So you get yourself a knee high that's about the same size as anything you want to stuff. I have a friend that just passed of breast cancer. And you can stuff it, you can stuff it with toilet paper. That's something, you know, I want to remember too, this whole thing about toilet paper. But what I did was, I'm not gonna do the whole thing for you because we're getting close on time. And then just squeeze it. Now, if you make a long one, you can get more stuff in it because you can theoretically make it the length of your stocking. The length of your stocking, right? Mm-hmm. You can take a square, sew up the sides, stuff it. And this one smells, I wish you could smell this. It's got lilacs in it. Lavender. It's got lavender seeds in it. I have a lavender bush that blooms for me every year.
So this isn't about seeing the stuff, Belinda. Like, you don't have to see the eyes that are made out of a mask or whatever. This is, you can sort of stuff something with the memories. I mean, I know it's art. You can do whatever you want. But I mean, the notion is just to gather up the things.
To gather up the things and to honor them by speaking about them.
Okay.
Because, you know, I knew there were ration cards because I knew what ration cards were. When it said ration cards, I knew what that was. But if someone picks up your doll 15, 20 years from now, if you have carefully documented who you are and what this experience was for you, then you have it not just for you, but you have it for whoever picks it up. So it's not just a memory for you, it's a discovery for someone else. And more than likely, it'll be somebody who loves you, who's going to be going through your things, and they're going to find it. And it's going to tell the story of you during this period of time. Are there any more questions, guys?
No.
Ladies, rather. You got it. I want you to know that if this is something you want to do and you want more information or to learn a little bit more about it, like this doll here, I have a my Advent doll. I don't know where I put her. This doll is like a pretty easy structure to what I could do for this one is make a pattern. And you could either blow it up or, you know, blow it down. And you could actually take and affix, because you could affix all kinds of stuff. I could actually cut this off and put this on her. I'll show you how I would do that real quick. I'm gonna cut this rectangle because it's about the size of her bodice there. And if I was gonna use this, the pattern that I have here, and I wanted to, I would take that same glue that decoupage glue, and I would glue it right on because it will adhere to this. That stuff's magic.
I just magic. Had a thought. Hmm? I just had a, you just gave me a thought.
What was that?
I feel like doing a Trump tweet doll.
That would be funny.
It's funny just to think about it.
Yeah, but just think if you collected all of those.
Yes, no, yes.
Put them in a jar. You know, and, you know, stuffed it and, because this, see how nicely she sits in there?
Oh.
Well, yeah, start collecting them. Somebody would really love to have that later.
Sure. I can probably sell them.
Sure, for sure. But these things are like any size, any, I mean, create. In the store, you may find these little things. They're little molds for faces. And that's where her face came from. This little face down here, I just used one of these faces. And here's one that I'm going to use. It just came out of one of those little rubber molds you can get at AC Moore. Oh, I'm sorry, Michaels. Yeah. AC Moore is gone, right?
Yeah, sad day.
Now, so I might even have an AC Moore bag that I'm going to put up. Because I used to love AC Moore.
You and me both.
So let me give you where you can find me. You can find me on Facebook and say, Belinda, could you post the pattern for your advent doll, or could you give me some more instruction about Mod Podge and how to use it, or whatever. I would take a picture of that, Diane, and use it. Yeah. That's behind you. I would take a picture of that. Yeah. I mean, that in and of itself could be a doll. You know, they have companies where they have fabric that mm-hmm. you can actually print something on.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You know?
And you could send them a JPEG
mm-hmm.
and they will print the photograph onto cloth fabric. So that mm-hmm. might be one way for you to capture that.
I told her she has to give it to me for my birthday because she doesn't have it hanging. You know how she is. She told me if I was good. Yeah.
Yeah, but I'd really like to see that memorialized in a, you know, in a big way.
Yeah.
In a big way. Any other questions? Now, if you really want to see me again this week, you can come to the Leadership Studio and take my yin class. I do that 7 o'clock on Monday evenings on the Leadership Studio Facebook page. So you have my email where you can, did I give you my email or just gave you my Facebook? Okay, email. Adila, Adilah, #1. @gmail.com. And I'd be willing to help you out with anything, little tips or whatever. I found there's some really neat products out there. Depending on how much you want to invest in this doll, because she could be as fancy as you want, or she can be just a simply rudimentary, primitive doll. But the most important thing is that you journal about the meaning of the doll, that everything has a meaning. Everything holds a memory. And encapsulate your color. And Michelle, even if you don't make it pink, give it a pink ribbon.
Okay.
Give it a pink ribbon because it wants something pink. You want something pink in there. Okay? And I'll
why?
Show.
Why? Because that's the first one.
That's the first thing you thought about was pink.
Yeah. I don't know. I think I'm just easily influenced. Like I just wow, like so bright. And then you said if you see blue, then I started seeing blue. Like it's so easy for me to just zig right. around.
It's fun to dig around. It's fun to dig around. Yeah, but I even have a pink ribbon you can use. So ladies, we're gonna have to get off here. It's really been wonderful.
This was great.
I have enjoyed being with you.
Thank you. Good job.
We'll have to do this again sometime.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
thank you.
Okay. Be well, everybody. Be
bye.
Safe. Bye.
Bye.